I'm Sheila Kern. I've been an artist my whole life, and I've just finished, 3 years in the making, the biggest undertaking of my artistic life. I love to create beautiful things. Turns out that the paintings I create impact the environment they're in, giving people a new perspective of themselves, or just making them feel good. 3 years ago, I moved back to the States after living in Europe for almost 20 years. And immediately I became consumed with images for a painting of a labyrinth. I had visited the famous labyrinth at Chartres Cathedral when I lived in Paris, and I flew to the mountains of Colorado and walked a labyrinth there at 8,000 feet. I understood walking a labyrinth as different things, a tool for self-alignment, balancing the hemispheres of your brain, an ancient mystery, or a form of pilgrimage. Is it biology and chemistry? Or spiritual and religious? Or is it just an archetype that's fundamental to all human experience? After all, they've been around for 4,000 years. Are we looking to find God or just self-understanding as we come into our own power? I was given the answer that the human mind is a labyrinth and that the labyrinth of your mind can rob you of every good thing in your life. Crap! I want to have a handle on that! I want to be able to navigate the labyrinth of my mind and have the outcomes I desire. Traditionally, a labyrinth is not designed to be difficult to navigate. There is a single path to the center and a single path back, as opposed to a maze that has many choice points that can lead to a wrong path or a dead end. In my labyrinth painting, there is one choice point of a right turn or a left turn, thereby having a completely different experience of the journey. Did you ever wonder what your life experiences would be if you had made a different choice at a crucial part in your life? In this labyrinth, you still end up at the center. You still get to the tree of life and get your crown, and the doves are released in triumph and celebration. It doesn't matter what choices you've made, you still win at the end. How great is that? Along the way, I've brought in myth, symbol and allegory, the romance of Camelot, heraldry and regency, Greek mythology, symbols of power, royalty and beauty, travel to another world through the looking glass, the great heroine Joan of Arc, my favorite statue in Paris, Venus, the ultimate feminine archetype, the enigmatic, Da Vinci's John the Baptist pointing the way, the Tree of Jesse from the cathedral in Reims, France, the mammoth gold key and its keyhole well into the journey, or just a peaceful place to rest, and what I believe to be the strongest desire of the human experience, the desire to be loved and to have love.